31, I had a question coming out of section 5.1, number 45. And here we were given the graph of a function, a parabola, and asked to find its equation. So when I get going on this, things that are good to look for, I always look for the vertex. And because this is a downward facing parabola, I have this vertex here, right? I can see the maximum, the vertex is a max in this case. And it looks like it's got the ordered pair negative 2, 3. So I'll keep that in mind. I notice my parabola, like I said, it's facing down, I should say downward probably, which means when I get going, I know whatever that a value is, it's going to be negative, right? It's going to be less than 0. And when I say the a value, eventually I'm going to get to something that's ax squared plus bx plus c. And all I'm saying here is that this number has got to be negative. Another thing that I could take note of, just going off of the graph, if I want to look at the c value, that's always the y-intercept. And it looks like I'm headed right through the ordered pair 0, 2, right? So at this point, I think when I get done with this, I'm going to have ax squared plus bx plus 2. That's my guess. And really, you need one other point, or at least one other point, I should say, to find the equation of the parabola. I could have also, just looking here, it looks like I also have an ordered pair of negative 4, 2. I mean, I have an infinite number of ordered pairs. It's just always nice to look for ordered pairs that cross at grid marks, right? I can see another one here. It looks like I could have used negative 6, negative 1, or it even looks like over here, 2, negative 1. So any of these ordered pairs will be good. The big one is the vertex. So if I'm going to use the vertex, again, it's got the ordered pair, or the coordinates h, comma, k. And if we look at the vertex formula for a parabola right here, I'm going to plug in negative 2 for h here and 3 for k, keeping in mind that when I do minus a negative 2, because that x coordinate, or I guess the x coordinate of the vertex, but the h value is negative, that's going to be x plus 2 once I do the algebra. So here is my parabola formula so far, and the only thing I'm missing is the a value. And again, if you want to find this a value, and actually I think I used the yellow highlighter before, if I want to find that a value, I just need to use any of these other ordered pairs that I have. And it doesn't matter which one. It looks like the one I wound up using when I wrote up the homework solutions, it looks like I used negative 4, 2. But just now in this video, as I'm here, it would have been actually easier for me to use 0, 2, just because I have that x coordinate of 0. But I'll go through with the negative 4, comma 2. It's not wrong to do it that way. So if I'm going to plug in negative 4, comma 2, I'm quite literally going to plug in negative 4 for the x value and 2 for the y value. And then I'm going to see what a is equal to. So that's what you see me doing here, right? There's the negative 4 in for the x. There's the 2 in for the y. And then we can do a little arithmetic here. So let me go through it. If I do negative 4 plus 2, that is quite literally negative 2. I still need to square that. And negative 2 squared is positive 4. And that's where I'm getting that 4a there. And so when I solve for a, I get my negative 1/4, which is great. And I'm going to take that negative 1/4. And again, let me get the color coding right. If this is negative a being negative 1/4, I'm going to substitute it in for my a value. And again, that's what you're seeing right here. And that's all fine and good. If I want to get it into standard form, I just need to, or I should say general form, I need to simplify that and multiply it out. Now, here I'm just cutting to the chase with my answer, but I'll go ahead and work it out for you just so you can see it. So this would be negative 1/4. And if I take x plus 2 squared, that's going to be x squared plus 4x plus 4. And then I have this plus 3. I'm going to distribute the negative 1/4 and I'll get negative 1/4 x squared minus x minus 1 plus 3. And when I simplify that a little bit, sure enough, I'm going to get negative 1/4 x squared minus x plus 2. And that's what you see here. And just looking at it, I did get that 2 for the y-intercept, which if we scroll all the way back up, I thought I was going to get just by looking at it. All right, so there's number 45. Thanks so much. Bye.